Talking about the different tastes of the substances around us, how many tastes can we classify the substances into? Gurmani?
Sour, bitter, sweet.
And? Salty. All right? So these are the four different types of taste. And if I have to classify substances around us on the basis of their chemical nature, you will notice that all the sour substances, they contain acids in them. All the bitter substances contain bases in them. And there is a class of compounds called salts or sweets which are neutral in nature. That is, they're neither acidic nor they are basic. Now talking about sour substances, give me an example of a naturally occurring substance that we use. Ritika?
Lime juice.
All right, that's sour in nature. That you have tomatoes, you have all the citrus fruits are sour. And vinegar that we use, tamarind, all these are sour substances. Now all these substances are sour because they contain something called acids in them. All right? That's what we're going to study today, about the properties of sour substances or bitter substances which chemically are acids or bases. All right? Acid has been derived from the word acidus, which means sour. Clear? So all these naturally occurring substances are sour, but you can't really taste all the acids that we have around. You must have heard about hydrochloric acid, sulfuric acid, nitric acid. Now they are all so strong acids that you can't taste them, isn't it? So acids can be classified further into two categories, as organic acid or mineral acids. As the name suggests, organic acids are a class of acids which are present in organic material, like something that has been devised from the natural sources, be it plant or be it animal. All right? For example, like the citrus fruits that we are saying, they're coming from the plants, isn't it? There's another acid called formic acid. Have you heard of formic acid? It is present in the sting of red ants. All right? So it is called formic acid because formica in Latin means red ant. So these acids have also devised their name from the basis of the substances they have been derived from. All right? But like I said, we cannot taste all the substances which are around us. And mineral acids are stronger acids. You can't even put it on your hands, isn't they? So corrosive, they might burn your hands. So nitric acid, sulfuric acid, these are very strong acids and they are derived from the minerals found in the earth. Like sulfuric acid, if I take the example, it is obtained from sulfur by carrying out obviously certain reactions. Same way with hydrochloric acid or nitric acid. Now to classify substances on the basis of their acidic or basic nature, you use a certain class of substances called indicators. What is the need of these indicators? Yes, to differentiate. If I want to know the nature of a chemical nature of a substance around me, you can't taste, isn't it? Because you might not know that unknown sample might be harmful to you. So you have to have certain substances which help us to identify the chemical nature of material around us. Either it's acidic or basic or it is neutral. So indicators means they indicate what the chemical nature of that substance is. Either it's acidic, basic or neutral. Now indicators are classified further into two categories, which are visual indicators. It means they change the color. You see the color change and then you identify on the basis of the color change that this particular substance is an acid. And then there is another class of indicators called olfactory indicators. Olfactory indicators related to the sense of smell, that is, you smell that particular substance which has a peculiar smell, and if it changes its smell, probably that particular substance is acidic or basic and so on. Alright, now coming to the visual indicators, further if we classify, there are certain natural indicators that we found in our everyday use, we are using them. For example, Akanksha, can you name a natural indicator?
Turmeric and red cabbage leaves.
Yes, turmeric, good. Or red cabbage leaves or China rose petals extract. These are all natural indicators which obviously you are using in our everyday life also. A very common example, I'll tell you, when vegetable dish gravy, it falls on the clothes, isn't it? And when we wash those clothes with soap solution, which is a base, the color of that spot changes to reddish brown, isn't it? Now why? Because turmeric here has acted as an indicator. So if you talk about natural indicators in case of visual indicators, you can name certain, like Akanksha has just told us, it is turmeric, China rose petals extract, red cabbage leaves. Now, this chapter, I'm sure in class 7th also when it was done, you were made aware, known to these indicators, isn't it? So when these indicators, we already know, then there are certain synthetic indicators. There are certain substances which are chemicals, all right? They don't really occur naturally, but they are synthetic or chemicals, which can also be used to test the chemical nature of a substance, whether it's acidic or basic or neutral. Two such indicators that we use in the lab very commonly are phenolphthalein and methyl orange. Now the color changes, and there's one more very natural indicator that we use very commonly in the Yes Gurmani. It is the litmus solution, all right, which is available in two colors, red and blue. Now we will discuss about the color changes of each type of indicator in an acidic and basic solution. And then I've got two unknown samples with me, which I do not know whether it's an acidic substance or a basic substance. But because we know the color changes of these indicators in acid is this and in base is this, so we're going to test the samples with those indicators. So quickly coming to the color changes of the indicators, we'll use blue litmus. Changes to red in acid, and red litmus changes to in base. But if I have to put red litmus in an acid, then there'll be no change. Alright, so red litmus can also be used to test the acidic substance. If you put that solution in a substance which you do not know whether it's an acid and base, and it doesn't change its color, it means it's an acid. And if it changes its color from red to blue, then that's a base. So red litmus changes to blue in base. That's one. Then talking about methyl orange. Now when you're talking about these indicators, or you should also know the original color, isn't it? Then only we're going to say, okay, this was the color change. Methyl orange, as the name itself suggests, it is orange in color. So it changes to red in acids and yellow in a base. Then phenolphthalein. Phenolphthalein is a colorless indicator which stays colorless in acid, but in case of base, it becomes dark pink or magenta. All right. So these are the various indicators, visual indicators or color indicators that we're going to talk about. Now we have two samples, and of which we really don't know which one is an acid and a base. But with the help of the indicators, we'll ascertain whether it's an acid or a base. When we take it in the test tube, and the indicator that I have used is blue litmus solution. All right. Now let's see whether the color of the blue litmus changes to some other color or not. Can you see the color change?
Yes.
What does it change to?
Yes.
So what do we ascertain? It is an acid. All right. If we want to test the same sample with another indicator, let's take phenolphthalein now. Phenolphthalein, all right, we'll skip phenolphthalein for acid because phenolphthalein stays colorless in an acid. Let's take methyl orange. Now methyl orange, I told you, is an indicator. It's a synthetic indicator. Natural indicator is derived from a natural source, and synthetic indicators are certain chemicals which, when react with these substances, produce a color change. Methyl orange will change to
red.
All right. So this also shows and confirms. In fact, we've already confirmed it. So we'll say that sample A is an acid. Doing the same test with sample B, which could be an acid. It's not necessarily that we've taken sample A as acid and sample B as base, isn't it? So by looking at the color change of the indicator, we'll find out whether it's an acid or a base. Let's put red litmus solution in it. This is red, which is a natural or a synthetic indicator. All right, we'll read from the book. There's a little information regarding the source of litmus, which is obtained from lichens, a symbiotic organism. So this is red litmus solution. When I pour in this, the color of this changes to blue. So it's a base, all right? Carrying out the same test of sample B with now phenolphthalein, all right? Phenolphthalein is by itself colorless, all right? So let's see the color change of phenolphthalein in case of sample B, which is dark pink or magenta, all right? So without actually doing any experiment as such, isn't it? We've not really done much of an experiment, but without knowing whether it's acidic or basic, but only by the use of these indicators, we can come to know whether it's an acid or a base. Now these are visual indicators. For some reason, if we are able to see things around, all right? So we can also find out whether a particular substance is acidic or basic with another class of indicators called olfactory indicators, which we have said that are related to the sense of smell. Three very common olfactory indicators are onion, yes, vanilla, or you have clove oil. Now how it is, like we have used these solutions which are available, all right, these indicators have been converted into solutions and we are using that solution to test the nature. But to impregnate or to find out the change of smell, you have to first impregnate these smells which are associated with these substances on strips of cloth. All right, there's an activity, please refer to your book on page 18. The activity 2.2, which tells you, take some finely chopped onions in a plastic bag along with some strips of clean cloth. Tie up the bag tightly and leave overnight in the fridge. The cloth strips can now be used to test for acid and bases. Now take two of these cloth strips and check their odor. Obviously it's a smell indicator, so we want to test the acidic or basic nature of the substance, whether that particular substance which has that peculiar smell, all these are peculiar smell, isn't it? Onion has a very pungent smell. As you cut or chop them, you can smell it. So if that cloth strip which has been impregnated with say onion or vanilla or clove oil, if you test it with a basic solution, if that characteristic odor is not smelt, it means it's a base, all right? But in case of acids, the characteristic odor would be smelt. So if I take that strip and I pour say sample B over it, so will you be able to smell the onion's peculiar smell? No, all right? Because we already know it's a sample, the sample is basic. But for acidic substances, these odors stay as it is. So they do not destroy the odor. This is talking about the characteristic of substances as acidic, basic on by the use of indicators, which are available as visual indicators, which change the color, something that you can see, and olfactory indicators, which change the smell of these indicators in presence of these substances. So please treat question number 1, 2, 3 as your homework, and that's all we have for the day.